are going to start Informatica, right? So what is Informatica actually? Any idea? Just I'm considering you as a student, so the very first question, you are trying to learn Informatica, right? What is it? So it's a application or database, or it's a, so it's a tool actually. So what does it mean? Tool means without tool, yes. Let's say you take any tool, yes, without tool we can able to work. So it's a tool. When you are talking about tool, where exactly you are going to use this tool? What is the purpose of this tool? So before going into Informatica, we should understand what is the purpose of this tool and where exactly we are going to use this tool. We are going to use this tool in the area of data warehousing. So what is data? So it's a collection of data, right? All of the information, collection of information. What is warehouse? Why we need warehouse for your data? So let me give you a simple example. Let's say you are a customer of ICICI Bank, or maybe you are applying for a credit card with ICICI Bank. Okay. So what you will do? So maybe you are applying for a credit card. You will go to bank, or maybe you are going to submit all your address proof, employment details, education details, everything you are going to submit. Then they will do background verification and they are going to issue a credit card for you, right? Let's say you are going to get a credit card. The type of card is gold, and your number is this, and you are from Hyderabad. So whenever they are issuing a credit card for you, the backend in the database, one record will be creating for you, and every month they are going to send monthly statements to your address, right? Fine. Let's say as part of job requirement, you moved from Hyderabad to Bengaluru. So what you will do as a customer? See, as a customer, you can call customer care center, or you can place a request online, or you can send a mail, or you can go to bank. You can place a request for change of address, right? Whenever you are requesting for change of address, are they going to take any address verification? Second time? Are you getting me? See, when you are trying to place a request, are they going to ask any documentation for address proof? No, right? Simply over the phone, your customer care executive, she will take your request and they will say within 24 hours your request will be processed.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So what's happening? So the existing data in the database, they are going to replace your phone number and your address with
new one.
Phone number, new address. Let's say your new phone number is this one, and if you move to Chennai, from Hyderabad to Chennai.
Yeah.
Now they are going to send this data to, every month they are going to send communications, monthly statements and everything to this number and to this mailing address. Let's say we are not going to make the payments. Then what they will do? They will give this data to recovery team. Recovery team will go to Chennai address. It's a fake address. Intentionally I changed it.
Yes.
So we don't have the initial address. For initial address, we did address verification, everything. We lost that address. So warehouse actually. So warehouse, in general, what is warehouse? Collection of stocks, right? You are going to keep some stocks.
Yeah.
Or you are going to have goods, stocks, items, whatever it may be. It's a warehouse. So we are calling it as a data warehouse.
Data.
So we are calling it as a data warehouse. So whenever there is a record creating for a customer, we are going to take that record and we are going to load that record into our warehouse.
Warehouse, okay, fine.
So this is our transactional database, actually. Whenever a record is creating, whenever a new customer, we will call it as a online transactional databases. Going forward, we will get more information. It's a OLTP. So online transactional processing. You are going to bank, you are going to withdraw something, or you are going to deposit something. Everything will be happening in this database. Okay, so whenever a new record is creating in this database, we are going to pull that record, we are going to extract, and we are going to load into this warehouse, another database. So how you are going to load data from one database to another database? Using a tool called Informatica.
Okay.
Using a tool called Informatica, and we are calling this tool as ETL tool.
ETL. Okay.
What is ETL tool? What we are doing? We are going to extract, we are pulling data from this database. We are going to load data into another database. In between, we will have some changes. After pulling data, we are going to change some format of the data as per the requirement. That is transformation. Going forward, we will understand what is transformation. So that is the reason we are calling this as ETL tool. So the advantage with the tool is, at a time you can communicate with n number of databases, and at a time you can load it into n number of databases. So this is the purpose of warehouse. So let's say now customer is placing a request. Whenever customer is placing a request for change of address, immediately the transaction database will be updating with new number.
And
immediately your tool, you are going to use a tool, right? Your tool will load the data from here to there. So in warehouse, it's a collection of data. You are going to maintain complete transaction history of your customer's data. Let's say now the customer is not going to make the payments. We are going to provide entire data to recovery team. Simply they will go to Chennai address. If it is fake, they will go to Hyderabad address, which is verified initially.
Okay.
Make sense?
So how many times we change the address, that many times it will be going to data.
Yes, because see, let's say you are taking a policy.
Yeah.
Simple. This is just one example to understand warehouse. Let's say you are taking a policy with some mutual fund you are taking. Okay. You can change from one fund to another fund, right? From debit fund to equity fund, growth fund.
Yeah.
Right. See, I am going to analyze customers' behavior. How many times customers changing in a year?
Mm.
Okay, and why they are changing? Let's say most of the customers changed in the month of December. Why? That time maybe the market is up or down, or some news is there. So we can analyze the data. So this is one example. So I can give you another example. Let's say the best example is, let's say recently we have mobile portability options, right?
Yeah.
So as a customer, you can change from existing network to some other network. Let's say we have a Airtel business. We have Airtel business. Assume in Hyderabad, one day, let's say if you want to place a request for mobile portability, you can send SMS, right?
Yeah.
People, they are placing SMS.
Few people,
they are going to store and they are placing a request.
Okay.
Few people, they are putting online request. Right? Or you can go to store, you can fill the application. So we are going to get data from all these source systems. So let's say today from Hyderabad city, let's say we got 1 lakh requests.
1 lakh
people today placed a request to change from existing Airtel to some other network. Assume you got 1 lakh requests from different source systems, SMS, source, online. So what you do? You are running a business, all your customers planning to change from your existing network to some other network. What you will do? Will you release? If you lose one customer, again getting another customer is difficult, right?
Yeah.
But how to hold all 1 lakh people? At least how to hold 50% of the people? So take all this data and load it into warehouse. From warehouse, you are going to generate different types of reports. Let's say all 1 lakh people data, I'm going to load it into a warehouse from immediately. Next morning 6th, today maybe within 24 hours we got different requests from different channels, maybe stores, from online or SMS, by phone, customer care, whatever the channels, we got 1 lakh requests. Immediately, just go and analyze your data. Have 1 lakh requests. How many people? Let's say if you take 1 lakh requests, let's say 50,000 people from a single plan. That is, let's say 999 plan. Remaining 10,000 from some 202, whatever the plan you have. So like this, you are going to analyze your data. Most of the people, 50% of the people from single plan. All other people are from different small plans. Why? Why most of the people are planning to change? So take this 50, see, you are getting customers request, right? Immediately take this 50,000 customers data for marketing team. Marketing team, what they will do, the next day they will call all the customers. Most of the times they will call randomly. Sir, you placed a request, you are a valuable customer with Airtel from last few years. Why you are planning to change? Right?
Okay.
See, we are going to analyze, we got 1 lakh requests. Out of 1 lakh requests, 50,000 requests from a single plan. Why most of the people planning to change from this plan? Okay. We don't know, right? So take this data and provide it to marketing team. Immediately marketing team, the next day they will call all the customers or randomly few of them to get the data. Why people are planning to change? What are the interesting plans available in the market? Right?
Okay.
So they will call few people randomly. Why you are planning to change? What is the problem? Then they will give some feedback. See, we are paying 999. But if I pay 999 in BSNL, I am going to get some 10 GB data free, let's say. Maybe that is the reason people are interested to change from existing network to some other network. So you are going to gather, you are going to collect feedback from customers, and you are going to generate a report like most of the people planning to change because of 10 GB free data available from BSNL network. So what you will do? So you are going to analyze immediately. Let's say right now we have 50,000 customers. Okay. All these 50,000 customers, let's say you are going to get at least 100 rupees profit per month. Okay. Now, if I am going to give 10 GB free, what will happen? Maybe my profit will come to 50 rupees.
Yeah.
Let's say, see, instead of losing all your customers, if I give 50 rupees discount, what will happen? If I give 10 GB free, what will happen? My profit will come down. So instead of losing 50,000 customers, it's better to give 10 GB free data, right?
Yes.
Because we have enough offices, enough establishment, employment. If you don't have customers, what is the purpose of running business? So when you have to take this decision, you are getting a request. Same day you have to load all the data into your warehouse. From your warehouse, send data to marketing team. Marketing team will do some survey. They will get some information. Okay, this is the attracting plan in the market. Because of this plan, all our customers are planning to change. So just go ahead and give same discount. So the next day you will get a call. Please sir, don't change. We will also give you 10 GB data free for the same plan. So all this we have to do within 24 hours or max 48 hours. That is the power of data warehousing. That is the reason the data warehousing, we will call it as a decision management system.
Okay, fine. Because all the data will be stored there.
Yes, from there, see, your high level CEO, let me give you another example. Let's say we have an insurance company.
Okay.
Let's say we have an insurance company. So like this, each and every business you can analyze. See, let's say we have an insurance company. Okay. Maybe we have some millions of customers. Okay. Now, every month we are expecting new customers. So what you will do to get new customers into the organization, what you will do? You will do some media publicity.
Yeah.
Right? Roadside campaigns. Yeah. Roadside, they are going to keep umbrella campaigns, right?
Yeah.
So is there any way to get new customers other than these channels?
That's it.
See, we have 100 millions of customers, right? We can request all our customers for references, right?
Yeah.
But is it possible every month?
No.
No, and you are a customer. If I am going to call every month and if I am requesting for some references,
I can't give.
Will you have it? No. You don't like that type of service, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So you have to analyze your data. Let's say you are going to take a policy, or our parents are going to take a policy. Whenever they are going to take a policy, you need to analyze your data. How you are going to contact your customers? There should be a proper reason. Let's say you have 100 millions of customers. Every month we cannot request all 100 millions of customers on blindly basis. There should be a proper reason. Go and analyze your all 100 millions of customers. Let's say whenever a customer is going to take a policy, you will provide its kids and dependents details, right?
Yes.
You are going to take a policy, you will provide your kids details, date of birth and everything. See, out of 100 millions, I am going to generate a simple report. I am going to analyze the data and I am going to generate a simple report, like in the coming December month, in the month of December 2015. How many customers? We have 100 millions of customers. How many customers kids are going to become majors? You got it? How many people turning into 19 years? How many customers kids? Let's say you are going to get some 10,000 people. So take this 10,000 customers data, give it to marketing team. They will contact each and every customer. Congratulations, sir, your kid is going to become major in the coming month. He is becoming major, he is completing 18 years. We have very good policies for adults. Why don't you take a new policy? Make sense? Definitely people will encourage, right? At least they will show interest, they will take policy. So you can do this type of report, simple report. Let's say in the month of January 2006, you are going to do some report. Maybe that time you are going to have 20,000 customers. Every month you will generate a report, give it to marketing team. They will contact all the customers. They will try to get more policies.
Okay.
Let's say in the month of February 2016, there is 1 lakh customers.
Yeah.
Then what you will do? Our target is there are 1 lakh customers. There are 1 lakh kids in the market. See, if you take years, here it's not mandatory, but if you go to years, you are becoming major means you should take policy.
Okay.
You have to take a policy, not from your service, maybe some other insurance company, they have to take a policy. So there are 1 lakh customers.
Yeah.
So our target is at least I want 50,000 policies. I want to sell 50,000 policies. Okay. So to get 50,000 policies, what should we do? Last year what happened? Let's say last year when I gave 10% customer 10% discount, what happened? When I gave 20% discount, what happened? See, you are running your business from last few years, right? You will have all this data and analysis, right? So out of 1 lakh people, if I want to get at least 50,000 customers, the previous history, previous experiences giving, like, you should give 50% discount. But if I give 50% discount, what will be the loss? If I give 50% discount, see, our target is there are 1 lakh people in the market.
Yeah.
We are planning to get 50,000 customers.
Okay.
We are planning to sell 50,000 policies. If I want to sell 50,000 policies, at least you should give 50% discount. But
yes.
If you give 50% discount,
50%.
Definitely it's a loss to the organization in the current financial.
Yes.
But what about profits in the future? If you get 50,000 customers, next 20 years, 50% discount, what will be the loss? And what will be the profit to the organization? But If I give 50% discount, will it be okay in this financial year, or we are in a position to handle that loss, or we should give at least 30 or 40% discount? So all this is management decision. See, all big MNCs, top companies, whenever they are launching a product, they will not have a single failure. they will never ever have a failure, because they will analyze the data, they will understand the market, then only they will launch a product. So that is the power of data warehousing. Without data warehousing, without analysis, simple, see, as a student you are going to attend number of demos, right? Why? Simple, you are going to gather some information. Who is the faculty? How many years of experience he has? What are the timings? What is the fees? All these are factors for you. You are going to attend n number of demos, you are going to gather information, then you are going to take a decision. So for simple decision taking training and all, it's a simple decision, you are going to gather information. Such a MNC, when they are going to launch a product, they are spending millions of amounts and all, how much analysis they have to do? Clear? So that is warehouse. Any questions? Fine. So coming to here, Informatica, it's a one type of ETL tool. Not only Informatica, we have data stays, ab initio, there are a lot of tools here. Once data is loaded into your warehouse, then your reporting people will come into picture. They are going to analyze the data and they are going to generate different types of reports. Trees, graph charts, if I give 10% discount, it will this much profit and loss. If I give 20% discount, it will this much profit and loss. So from data warehousing, you will see reporting people. Reporting people will come into the picture. They are going to generate reports from here. Reporting tools is MicroStrategy, QuickView, Cognos, all these are reporting tools. So in your warehousing, in the area of data warehousing, we will have two types of tools. One is ETL and one more is reporting tool. So this is the area where we are going to apply all these tools. Any questions? Fine. So this is all about just the introduction of data warehousing and where exactly we are going to use Informatica.